Welcome again to Save to Serve and Prophesy Again Ministries for another Prophetic Insights, where we look at current events as they are fulfilling the Word of God, specifically end time prophecies found in the books of Daniel and even Revelation. Now, this evening, we are going to be covering some very startling current events as we see the close of human probation is about to take place. So kindly get your notepads, your writing instruments, and take some notes. And the first scripture we want to bring your minds to is Revelation chapter 8 and chapter 9. For in the Bible, how many trumpets do we find specifically laid out in the book of the Revelation, Hillary?
We find seven trumpets.
And we know seven typifies what in scripture?
Completion.
And these seven trumpets that we find in the eighth chapter of the Revelation, they are divided into two parts. There are simply the first four trumpets, and the last three trumpets are linked to what three things?
To woes.
Woe, woe, woe. That means the fifth trumpet is the first woe, the sixth trumpet, the second woe, and the seventh trumpet, the third woe. And we saw in the fifth trumpet, sixth trumpet, the first and second woes, which power does the Bible show us and also history confirms did terrorize mankind?
Islam.
All right. So in the first woe, second woe, fifth trumpet, sixth trumpet, the power of Islam terrorizing the world. Now, we saw, based on scripture prophecy and current events, even history, August 11th, 1840, that Turkey failed. No longer was Islam terrorizing the world. What was that date again, Hillary?
It was August 11th of 1840.
All right. And that was the end of the Second War. All right. Now, notice, when this Second War came to an end, August 11th, 1840, what opened October 22nd, 1844?
The investigative judgment.
All right. Don't forget that. Now, this day in history, we saw just a few days ago, August 10th, August 11th, 2018, that the media is now reporting that Turkey's economy is about to crash, as well as this may trigger another global financial crisis. Now, here it is on the screen, my friends. Headline, Hillary, August 12, 2018.
Erdogan accuses U.S. of waging economic war against Turkey as he threatens to look for new allies.
Now notice, it says here, headline, Hillary, Washington Post, August 13th.
Turkey's currency plunge fans fears of new global financial crisis. Turkey's ills have been inflamed by President Trump's abrupt move on Friday.
And that is August 10th, August 11th. All right, read on.
Yes. Abrupt move on Friday to double tariffs on imported Turkish metals in a bid to punish Erdogan for refusing to free an American pastor held on terrorism-related charges. Turkey's predicament is largely the result of its own errors. But the nation of 80 million is unlikely to be the only casualty of the shifting financial climate, which stems from changes in policy at the Federal Reserve.
And what?
The federal changes in policy at the Federal Reserve and other central banks.
Don't forget that last phrase, all right? And before we get there, so we see that this day in history, right? August 11th, 1840, August 11th, 2018. And August 11th, 1840 brought to an end the Second War, Sixth Trumpet, 1840 through 1844. And what opened?
The investigative judgment.
All right, October 22nd, 1844.
Right.
Now we are seeing that Islam is rearing its ugly head again to terrorize certain parts of the world, which shows us then that in the third woe, seventh trumpet, we must see the work of Islam rising to be a power, a force to reckon with in the world. And when we see, again, I don't want anyone to miss this. So in the first woe, Islam. Second woe?
Islam.
So in the third woe, what must we also find?
Islam again.
Since the seven trumpets are broken into two parts, four trumpets, last three, woe, woe, woe. So now that we see that Turkey is rising to power again, a force to reckon with. Radical Islam is being taught to us, is terrorizing mankind. What is about to close now, Hillary?
The work of investigative judgment in the heavenly sanctuary.
And that's why we're here. So that simply means the work of radical Islam, even Turkey, must play a central, key, important role in end time prophecy. And this brings us back to Genesis chapter 16, verse 10, verse 11, verse 12. And what does the Bible say there about Ishmael, the so-called father of Islam?
That every man's hand is to be against him and his hand against every man.
So that simply means then that the work of Islam in the last days is going to bring a confederacy of the powers that be in the world, church and state, and then those hands collectively will turn against which group of people, Hillary?
Against God's commandment-keeping people. And interestingly, the economy has something to do with it because it says here that the currency plunge in Turkey is supposed to affect the whole global economy. And we know that they're going to call for Sunday not only to combat immorality, violence, terrorism, but also to restore the nation back to temporal prosperity of economic crisis.
And notice, back to the screen, the last phrase in Turkey, which stems from changes in policy at the Federal Reserve and other what, Hillary?
Other central banks.
Now, don't forget this, viewers, Safe to Serve International Online, don't forget this, and that is that the economic crisis that is to come is not necessarily coming from the stock market. No, it's coming from the Federal Reserve and other central banks. Now, based on prophecy, Hillary, which power today has formed a confederacy with the merchants who control the Federal Reserve in America and other central banks, the IMF, World Bank?
The Roman Catholic Church.
And put this scripture down, Revelation 18, verse 2. Verse 3, notice now what we see here on the screen. This is Erdogan. And what does he do, Hillary Headline?
He blasts central bank over interest rate policy.
And this shows us that Erdogan he is striving to have control of the central bank in Turkey. From top, Hillary, what it says there, quickly.
We held a meeting on interest rates just before I went for an overseas trip. Mm-hmm. We spoke about how to lower them, but the central bank increased the rates when I was abroad. They always speak of one-man rule in Turkey, but what sort of a one-man rule is this? They do not implement the decision we took. They have gone behind my back.
And then he says, they are independent. Who is he saying is independent?
The central bank.
All right, well, it is us who are paying the price of their decisions. I always warn them to lower interest rates. They say okay in the meetings, but then they make what, Hillary?
The opposite interest rate regulation.
So who is he combating with?
The central banks.
All right, notice what this says here as we move on. And this is July 5th, 2018, and this on the screen confirms who is the one, which entity is in confederacy with the Federal Reserve and the central banks, including the IMF and also the World Bank. It is the Vatican, fulfilling Revelation 18, verse 2, verse 3, as well as Daniel chapter 11, verse 40 through verse 43. The world will be at the steps of the man of sin.
That's and right.
Here it is on the screen again. Even the recent Bilderberg meeting, and who was the one as a powerful influencer, mover, and shaker at that meeting?
It was the cardinal, a Roman Catholic cardinal. And it's interesting that he was the only one, and this is the first time that they've had a religious leader at the Bilderberg meeting. So, of course, everybody would be looking to that one individual, the one representative of the religious community, if you will, for advice, for his perspective on, you know, whatever issues they discussed, namely the economy.
Now, let's move on from Erdogan and what's happening, the coming crisis. Let's take a look at the media, because this is going to be a larger portion of our prophetic insights in this segment. Notice what this says here. This is, Hillary, talk to us. What's happening here with the threat against freedom of speech and the press?
Well, of course, President Trump is talking about the regulation or the shutting down of certain presses, fake news, because of what he terms fake news. So in other words, there's an attack on freedom of speech and also freedom of the press.
Democracy as we know it, you have to have a free and many times adversarial press. And without it, I'm afraid that we would lose so much of our individual liberties over time. That's how dictators get started.
It's fake, phony.
Fake news. This fake news.
Now tell us the connection now between President Trump and Alex Jones.
Well, of course, it's no secret that Alex Jones is a major supporter of President Trump, and he has been ever since the election, the campaign trail. He was rallying for President Trump and so forth. And so he says recently, after he had been banned from these various platforms, he recently said he was banned because of his support of Donald Trump. And he believed that because of the support he lent to Donald Trump, that was partially responsible for Trump getting into office. And they didn't like that. So, hey, now he's banned.
So now notice, let's make it very plain to our people. Here we have Alex Jones, who's on record stating that he supports Trump, right? Mm-hmm. And as a result, Facebook, YouTube, Spotify, etc., Apple banned him, right? So he's for Trump. They banned him. Those presses, those media outlets, corporate,
technology companies.
Now, And what is Trump also pushing?
For the banning of media.
Notice, InfoWars is widely credited with having played a key role in electing who?
Donald Trump. By banning InfoWars, big tech is engaging in election meddling just 3 months before crucial midterms.
So Facebook, YouTube, etc. banned him, Alex Jones, because he was doing what? Also supporting
Donald Trump.
And what is Trump now pushing?
And now Trump is pushing for the very thing that happened to Alex Jones, only on the other side of the spectrum. He's calling for, what you would call liberal media to be banned because of fake news, as he calls it.
Can you all see this? All right, it's right there on the screen. And we have covered this a few days ago. Now notice this, these words. It says here, coordinated purge. Facebook, YouTube, Apple, Spotify permanently ban Alex Jones and InfoWars. What's the key phrase here, Hillary?
Coordinated.
All right, now notice, we came across this article, which we were going to show this past Sabbath. But let's drop it right here. August 2nd, 2018. What is our headline here, Hillary?
Visualizing how the 50 largest U.S. companies are connected.
What's happening here?
Well, you see this tangled web chart here, but it mentions the top 50 companies in the United States and how they share board members. Most of them share board members between themselves, very easily. To be understood.
And notice, what do board members do for a company?
They make decisions.
Okay, so if you have, let's say, 7 board members, let's pick one of these, Apple, 7 board members on Apple and Facebook, if they decide to ban person A, but notice now, YouTube's board has some members from Facebook's board. Make sense now, friends?
Right.
So if these board members voted to ban person A from Facebook's platform, makes sense now?
Correct.
And now YouTube shares the same board members. What will happen to person A if he has materials on YouTube?
Well, he'll be banned from there as well.
And that's what we're seeing here. Here it is, friends. For any corporation, the board of directors plays a crucial role in corporate governance.
Elected by the company's shareholders, the board is meant to represent shareholder interests. It ultimately hires the CEOs, sets strategic objectives, approves annual budgets, and provides accountability to the shareholders regarding the performance of the organization.
To locate a qualified candidate, one option is to hire someone that already has experience working on a big corporate board. And because it's a part-time gig, people can actually be on multiple boards at once.
Today's data visualization reveals that 78% of the multi-billion dollar companies here have at least one board connection with another company on the list.
Hillary, give us some of these companies.
Okay, some of them are Walmart, Home Depot.
So that means we are, now there are many others, but we're focusing on places that many of us shop or relate to on a daily basis. Walmart, who else, Hillary?
Home Depot.
Home Depot, okay.
Boeing, that's the traveling.
Travel, okay.
Okay, you have IBM, Alphabet, Microsoft.
Now, Alphabet is the parent company for Google and other companies, all right?
Okay.
Again, that's technology, internet, go ahead.
Microsoft, Amazon, Facebook, Apple.
All right.
Then on the banking side of it, you have Wells Fargo, you have Citigroup, JP Morgan, Chase, as it relates to credit, shopping, you have Visa, and then you also have...
What about Amazon?
Yeah, I think I...
Okay.
Yeah, Amazon is there. You have Chevron, Exxon Mobil, General Electric.
Now, what about your phone, like AT&T and Comcast? So once they begin to ban you on one platform, and the banning must begin with the board members, right? And since they all share board members, if they red flag you on one platform, then what happens? A domino effect.
That's right.
Come
so
on,
it affects traveling.
Yes.
Because Boeing, it affects shopping.
Correct.
You have the Walmart and the Home Depot. If you're deemed a terrorism,
correct,
the technology, platform, media, the banking system, the
in
list goes
selected
on and on.
Messages, book 2, page 142, which says this, the work of the people of God is what, Hillary?
Is to prepare for the events of the future, which will soon come upon them with blinding force.
In the world, gigantic monopolies will be formed.
Men will bind themselves together in unions that will wrap them in the folds of the enemy.
A few men will combine to grasp all the means to be obtained in what, Hillary?
In certain lines of business.
I mean, are we seeing this?
Yes.
All right, so we are here, friends. Oh, yes. The last days are right upon us. Notice now what we saw happened to Alex Jones and others, which we know it's just a pawn in the big drama of the controversy. These things have been planned months before. Headline says...
By the board, the shared board.
Thank you, Hillary. Tech giants team up to fight extremism following cries that they allow terrorism. And bear in mind, there is a definition of who an extremist is, a fundamentalist is, those who believe in what?
In absolute truth.
All right, Hillary, from top, what it says here.
Facebook, YouTube, Twitter, and Microsoft have created a joint forum to counter terrorism following years of criticisms that the technology corporations have failed to block violent extremists and propaganda on their platforms.
All right, through a partnership with the WHO, a United Nations now, counter-terrorism committee, and a range of organizations. We want to find out who are some of these organizations.
Right.
The tech firms said they would also identify how best to counter extremism and online hate while respecting, as they say, freedom of expression and privacy when they're doing the opposite.
The opposite.
Notice here, friends, watch carefully. Headline, Facebook, Twitter, Google, and
Microsoft
team up to tackle what content?
Extremist content.
And this
content
is not only videos and text posts, but also memes. If you draw something, there's a way for them to identify if that drawing that you have posted has hate speech, hate content, extremist content, fundamentalist content. Hillary, from top, the companies.
Wow. The companies are to create a shared database of unique digital fingerprints known as hashes.
Don't forget that.
For images and videos that promote terrorism.
There it is.
This could include recruitment videos, so that means it could be evangelism videos.
Or
violent terrorist imagery or memes.
All right. When one company identifies and removes such a piece of content, the others will be able to use the hash, don't forget that term, the hash, to identify and remove the same piece of content from their own network. The strength of the photo what?
Photo DNA.
Interesting. The strength of photo DNA comes from the single central database, he said.
Wow, central bank, central database.
Thank you, Hillary. if it's removed from one site, it's removed where?
From everywhere. Removed everywhere. That's incredibly powerful. It's less powerful if it gets removed from Facebook and not from Twitter and YouTube. What we want is to eliminate this global megaphone that social media gives to groups like ISIS. Mm. So I guess in their estimation, Alex Jones was a terrorist group.
This doesn't get done by writing a press release. Technology companies have been under pressure from what?
From governments around the world.
Over what, Hillary?
Over the spread of extremist propaganda.
And look here, as we would say colloquially, look here. The Atlantic, who also has his hands meddling to control the tech companies.
So it's not just the government, but it's also Pope Francis, the
man of
sin.
And not only the bankers, but we have the tech industry, Silicon Valley, the Vatican, it says. And not only do we see church and state marrying, look at this, the Vatican is wooing Silicon Valley and the what now, Hillary?
And the tech sector is flirting back. The hackathon was just the latest example of the Vatican's outreach to the tech sector. Mm. So this is another form of their evangelization.
Correct.
Here to take control of the technology. Under Pope Francis, the Catholic Church has been courting Silicon Valley for years.
So the church is not only courting the civil leaders, but also the private corporation leaders, tech companies, right?
Right, she's the mother of harlots.
That's it. And these days, Silicon Valley is flirting right back, both priests and entrepreneurs. Church and state, right? Mm-hmm. Say a relationship between their two realms. What, Hillary?
Disparate as they are, can be mutually beneficial.
So not only church and state, but we see the church with the worldlings, right? Mm-hmm. Each world has an image problem with which the other can help. And yet each world also arguably has different core values that in some cases directly conflict.
The church has struggled to define and redefine its ambivalent relationship to technology over a period of centuries.
Now, we don't want to give too much here. The last sentence is very startling. Catholics were known innovators. Finish that last phrase, Hillary, to the point what now?
To the point that it's been argued the Catholic Church was actually the Silicon Valley of the Middle Ages.
And this brings us to our last point now. Because what happened in the Middle Ages, even the Dark Ages, the time of the Reformers? What happened with the press?
Right. We saw Martin Luther, of course, was able to widely disseminate his 95 theses through the press and through people transcribing it and just scattering them. And thus, a great impetus was given to the Protestant Reformation.
And notice here, so now, since that's the case, we are going to read now how the Vatican themselves said the Jesuits were the ones who actually used the press to counter the Protestant Reformation. Look what this says here. So now, since she did it then, between 538 and 1798, what must we expect from the papacy as it relates to the press?
To take control of the press through its Jesuit Pope.
Take it away. Turns out the Vatican hackathon isn't really about hacking, or is it?
Ruiz also stressed that the Secretariat of State, the Vatican's most important decision-making body, granted permission for the event to be called a Vatican hackathon. This happened in March of this year.
Correct. And then it says, bolded section.
Okay.
Zerny suggested that the coming together of the church and technology, the hackathon, is intended to represent it's not a new thing. Amen. Move on. It was we Jesuits, also with the Dominicans, Franciscans, etc., who embraced the printing press in what century?
In the 16th century.
The 1500s, right? Mm-hmm. And did with it what we want to do with today's new technology. Learning to use what God has inspired his people to invent. Generally, it's not owners of tech companies who approach the church. But what, Hillary?
It's the church who embraces the technology.
For what purpose?
To take control of it, shut down anything that would expose the church's abominations, and to basically spread its message. of Roman Catholicism.
In closing, and what did the papacy say came to an end between October 31st, 2016 to October 31st, 2017?
The protest, the Protestant
and
Reformation.
And what was one of the primary medium that the reformers used to get the gospel out and also to weaken the power of the papacy over the masses?
They used the press.
So what will she do today?
She will
come on, friends.
She will try to prevent those avenues so the gospel
so
can't
what must
get
we
out.
Do today, Safe to Serve, is to use every means possible to get the gospel out. Amen?
Amen.
All right. We leave it there until we return for another episode, segment of Prophetic Insights.